In 2002, one of the best games on the PS2 and for me ever was released, and that was Final Fantasy X. Final Fantasy X, this game was so good. It was a Wednesday, yes, I know that. It was very hot, and my mother got this game for me. I paid it, but she got it for me. And I was like, the school day was like, I think it lasted for 70 hours because it was slowly. When I got home, I rushed to my bag, I got Final Fantasy X, I put it on my PS2 and I played it for around, you know, till 9, because I always had to go to sleep in 9 o'clock. So I played it for weeks and weeks and weeks, even for years. I played it out around 10 times. So this is definitely my most played game on the PS2. And it's just an awesome experience. I don't know how I you know, should describe it, but I just loved all the characters. I really loved Yuna. And Lulu is awesome. I loved Waka. I loved, you know, Tidus was a little bit, you know, gay, but whatever. And I loved Seymour. I loved the whole story, the whole atmospheric depth. I totally loved the music. Loved. And so this game is really good. Every RPG owner should have Final Fantasy X, of course. I mean, duh. For the generation of the PlayStation 2, Xbox and GameCube, something drastically happened to the consoles. For the first time ever, I know Dreamcast also had it, but not really good. For the first time ever, the online component was built into the consoles. I mean, you can play online because the PS2 had like this peripheral that you should add onto it. But still, the first game that mostly everyone ever have played on a PS2 was SOCOM 1. And when I got SOCOM 1, the online wasn't there. It was like a couple of months later. But when I got this, oh shit, this game was so awesome. I mean, it was the first time I ever played online. I could even talk to people with my PS2. I didn't have a need of a PC or a laptop anymore. I could just play it, 16 players, battles. It was so awesome. I played it a lot of this game. It has such a lot of good memories of it, of me, you know, playing games. And sometimes I did own, but most of the time I got owned. Because even though I love SOCOM series, I'm not really that good into shooters. And especially not tactical shooters. Because I am tactical, but a little bit too tactical. And I mean, you know, I just, you know, go to you know, defense against walls and stuff, but everyone is like shotgun, poof poof poof, dead, because I always die, but whatever. But this is really a really cool game. I have really good memories of it. I kind of sold it a couple of years back, but I rebought it, of course, because, you know, and now I'm making my collection, and SOCOM should be in it. SOCOM is awesome. And that's just it. Everybody should have played. Everybody has played SOCOM if you have played on the PS2 online. And now my last game, but definitely not the least. At kind of the end of the PS2 era, is not really the end, but almost the end. Sony Santa Monica Studio with David Jaffe made something really big. I wasn't really hyped for it because at the time I didn't like see an internet website. I just heard here and there about something called God of War. I was like, you know, God of War, what is that? I've heard it was really brutal and the graphics were freaking amazing. And you can like destroy entire bodies together, you know, and destroy everybody and kill everybody. That's what I only heard. I mean, seriously, I didn't know what God of War was. Until I think like I see some reviews and I saw like it's like in the Greek mythology and you could, you know, with all kinds of beasts and do incredible, awesome, sick combos. And that time I got, of course, God of War, and that of course changed the whole action game genre forever, hack and slash genre, because this game has, I think, the best graphics, or maybe God of War 2, but the God of War franchise has the best graphics on the PlayStation 2, and God of War 3 looks freaking sick. But God of War 1 was awesome at the time, and the graphics are fucking, my dogs want to go in, my doggy, here, this is the dog, it always teases me, here is the dog,
look, look, he wants to go to sleep, but oh no, I can't. This is the dog that always harassing me when I make my videos. Now you can see the dog, the famous dog that always barks and harasses me in my videos. But whatever, now on to still on to the God of War chatting or bullshitting, I don't know, ranting, whatever. So when I finally got God of War, I played it, and of course the graphics are amazing. I didn't have a big screen like now, I have like this big of a screen, and my TV was over there. I got like, at that time, like 40 games maybe. But this game was freaking awesome. The graphics were amazing, the gameplay was amazing. I'm a little bit like, you know, say this, so I was like freaking awesome that you could tear everybody apart. It's really cool, and I really love this. The God of War series is incredible, and I'm so looking forward to God of War 3. Of course, the PlayStation 2 had thousands of really cool games. I can't mention them all, of course, I don't own them all. But this entire weekend will be all to the PS2, so a lot of reviews. Not those long reviews, but like reviews like 2 or 1 minute, 1 or 2 minutes. Just talking about it and showing the rating, whatever. So, you know, PlayStation 2. Happy birthday, and Sony, thanks for all the good memories. I hope you like this video, and see you maybe tomorrow, of course. Little side note, I'm really looking forward to hearing or seeing your memories of your time on the PS2. So if you like, comment on the video, tell what your memories are, or even cooler, make a video response, will be incredible awesome. Of course, I approve every video message or reply, but not advertisements, but just replies. So really cool. I'm looking forward to it. And again, see you tomorrow. I know.